Okay, children, now we have come on day 17th. Day 17th is dealing with area, number, knowledge and operations. Unit is indices. Subunit is introduction of indices. So indices you all have learnt in your previous standard. So in concept corner, let us recall. Find the following product. If you find this the product given here, what will be the answers? 2 into 2 here, you can see 2 into 2, answer is 4. 2 into 2 into 2, answer is 8, because 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. Then 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, answer is 16, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16. So in this way we can find the answer of the product. Product means multiplication. But when we want to write this product in indices form, in index form, how to write this product in index form? Let us see here. We can write this 2 into 2 as 2 raised to 2, 2 times 2, 2 multiplied by itself 2 times. So we have to write it as 2 square. When 2 into 2 into 2, that means 2 multiplied by itself 3 times, how to write 2 raised to 3. And when 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 2 multiplied by itself 4 times, we have to write it as 2 raised to 4. 4 at top, 2 at base. So in this way, we have to write or we have to express the product form into index form. So from this what we can say that if you multiply 2 by 2, 2 times 2 is written as power of 2. Here we can see 2 is written as power of 2. When 2 is multiplied by 2, 3 times 3 is written as power of 2. 3 is written as power of 2. And when 2 is multiplied by 2, 4 times 4 is written as the power of 2 here. In this way, we can write in the form of power, that is known as index form. So, from this what we can understand? We can say that when a number is multiplied by itself, how many times is written as the power of that number? So, for example, 2 raised to 3. In 2 raised to 3, 2 is the base and 3 is the index. When I write 2 raised to 3, this number written below is known as base and number written at the top is known as index, or sometimes that number is also known as power. Index and power is same thing. Okay, so 6 raised to 5. In this number, 6 is the base and 5 is the index. And what does it mean? 6 is multiplied by 6 5 times. And in multiplication form, 6 raised to 5 can be written as 6 into 6 into 6 into 6 into 6 5 times. That means what? 6 raised to 5. So this is known as product form and this is known as index form. When we write in the base and index, we can say it is in the index form. So number which can be written with base and power is known as indexed number. And it is index form. So from this what we can understand, a number is multiplied by itself in one or number of times, then that number of times is called index or power of that number. Okay, so this is first point which you have to remember. Second point is the number formed by the base and its power is called exponential number. If I write 6 raised to 5, this 6 raised to 5 number is known as exponential number. Exponential number is obtained by multiplying the number by itself. So this number can be obtained by multiplying the number by itself. That means 6 raised to 5 can be obtained how? 6 into 6 into 6 into 6 into 6, 5 times 6. So in this way we can obtain the exponential form of the given number. So let us see what is there in the practice corner. See, in practice corner few examples are given. The numbers are written in multiplication and exponential form. Try to understand them. First example is 4 into 4 into 4. How to write it in the exponential form or index form? We can say it as 4 into 4 into 4 is 4 raised to 3. 4 is multiplied by itself 3 times, that means 4 raised to 3. 4 is the base, 3 is the index. Now let us see second example. Minus 5 multiplied by minus 5. Minus 5 multiplied by itself 2 times. That means what? How to write in the index form? It is minus 5 raised to 2. It is multiplied by itself 2 times. And that's why 2 is the index and minus 5 is the base. Now let us see third example. In third example, which is the base? 2 upon 3, 2 upon 3, 2 upon 3, 2 upon 3. 4 times multiplied by itself. That means how to write in the index form? 2 upon 3 raised to 4. Same number multiplied by itself 4 times, and that's why 4 is the index or 4 is the power. And the number 2 upon 3 is the base. Now in second example, exponential form is given and we have to write in the product form. 9 raised to 3. How to write in the product form? 9 into 9 into 9, 3 times. Minus 4 raised to 3. How to write in the product form? Minus 4 multiplied by minus 4 multiplied by minus 4, 3 times. In this way, we can solve the sums of index form and product form. So here we have given one chart. We have to make a tick mark in true or false. This sum we will solve in our notebook. Bridge course notebook. So let us solve in the bridge course notebook. So here it is my notebook, and you all can see my activity sheet number 17. I have written the area, number, knowledge and operations. Unit is indices, subunit is introduction of indices. In practice corner we have to solve this. Write tick mark and cross mark at the correct places. So in first example, 5 raised to 4 is equal to 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. Is it correct? Because 5 raised to 4 means 5 multiplied by 5 4 times. Correct? So here we can see that 5 is multiplied by 5 4 times. That means it is true. In true, we have to make tick mark. In false, we have to make cross mark. Okay. Now 3 raised to 4. 3 raised to 4 means what? 3 should be multiplied by itself 4 times. Actual correct answer should be 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, 4 times. But what is given to us? 4 multiplied by 4, 3 times. That means it is wrong. It is false. False is correct. True is not correct. Okay. Now let us see. 9 into 9 into 9. That means what? 9 multiplied by itself 3 times. How it can be expressed in index form? 9 raised to 3. That means this is correct. So this is true. And for false, we have to put cross mark. Now, 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, 5 times. 3 multiplied by itself 5 times. So, in index form, we have to write it as 3 raised to 5. So, it is correct. It is true. And in false, we have to put cross mark. Next one, minus 2 upon 5 raised to 2. It means what? Minus 2 upon 5 multiplied by itself 2 times. Is it shown here? Yes, it is equal to minus 2 upon 5 multiplied by minus 2 upon 5. That means it is correct. Minus 2 upon 5 multiplied by itself 2 times. So it is correct. So it is true. And in false, we have to put a cross mark. Now let us see next one. Minus 6 multiplied by minus 6. How we can convert it into the index form? That means what? Minus 6 raised to 2. Minus 6 multiplied by itself 2 times. It means it should be minus 6 raised to 2. But instead of that, what is given to us? 3 raised to minus 6. That means this is wrong. Wrong is correct and true is not correct. So in this way, you can complete this activity table in activity sheet number 17. Now we go on next day. Okay children, so we are going to continue with day 18th in the same video, because day 18th is dealing with area, number, knowledge and operations on number. Unit is indices and the subunit is rules of indices. Rules of indices we all have learnt in our previous standard. So in concept corner, what is there? Let us observe the following maths fun. This maths fun you have to observe, you have to read it and try to solve it. We will go directly on the rules of indices which we have learnt before. So, 5 rules of indices are there. First rule is rule of multiplication. Can you see here? A raised to x multiplied by a raised to y is equal to a raised to x plus y. That means base is same. A raised to x multiplied by a raised to y. We can see the bases are same. A is the base. But the index are different and there is multiplication between two numbers. These numbers are known as exponential numbers. That means they are having base and index form, and that's why they are exponential numbers. So when there is multiplication between two exponential numbers, their bases are same and the index are different. How to solve this? We have to write base one time, common base one time, and we have to add the indices x plus y. We have to add it. Example is given: a raised to 3 multiplied by a raised to 2 is equal to a raised to 3 plus 2 is equal to a raised to 5. One more example I can give you: 5 raised to 4 multiplied by 5 raised to 5. Okay, 5 raised to 4 multiplied by 5 raised to 5. We can see same base is there and there is multiplication between two exponential numbers. So what should be done? Write the base one time and add the indices. 4 plus 5, in the place of indices we have to add the indices. So what will be the answer? We have to write base again as it is, and 4 plus 5, index will be 9, 5 raised to 9. So answer of 5 raised to 4 multiplied by 5 raised to 5 is 5 raised to 9. This is known as rule of multiplication of indices. Now let us see the rule of division. In division, what is there? A raised to x divided by a raised to y is equal to a raised to x minus y. In multiplication, we add indices, and in division, we subtract the indices. So when the bases are same, there is division between two numbers. We have to write the base one time and we have to subtract the indices. The example is given: a raised to 6 divided by a raised to 2 is equal to a raised to 6 minus 2 is equal to a raised to 4. So if I give one more example: 8 raised to 7 divided by 8 raised to 4, division is there. So when the division is there and bases are same, you can see bases are same in both the numbers. So we write base one time and we subtract the indices, 7 minus 4. So answer will be, we write base again as it is, 7 minus 4, answer is 3. So answer of 8 raised to 7 divided by 8 raised to 4 is 8 raised to 3. So in this way, when division is there, we subtract indices, and when multiplication is there, we add indices. Now let us see what is the third rule. In third rule, we can see that there is one base and two indices. A raised to x raised to y. One base, two indices. So when one base and two indices are there, a raised to x raised to y, what we have to do? We have to write index one time. Sorry, we have to write base one time and we have to multiply the indices. A raised to x multiplied by y. Here one example is given: a raised to 2 raised to 3. One base A and 2 and 3, 2 indices. So we have to multiply. A raised to 2 multiplied by 3. Answer is A raised to 6. One more example I can give here: 5 raised to 3 raised to 4. Okay. So 5 is one base and 2 indices, 3 and 4. So I can write it as 5 raised to 3 multiplied by 4. We can do this multiplication. So 5 base, write as it is and do this multiplication. 3, 4 is 12. So answer is 5 raised to 12. 5 raised to 3 raised to 4 means 5 raised to 12. So when one base and two indices are there, we have to write base as it is and multiply the indices. Now let us see what is the fourth rule. Fourth rule is a raised to 0, answer is 1. What does it mean? It means that when the index is 0 to any number, any integer, any fraction, any whole number, natural number, any type of number, when the index is 0, answer should be 1. You can write 100 raised to 0, answer will be 1. If you want, you can write minus 5 upon 7 raised to 0, answer is 1. When raised to 0, when the power is 0, when the index is 0, answer is always 1. If I write x and raised to 0, answer is 1. If I write 98 raised to 0, answer will be 1. If I write 1257 raised to 0, answer will be 1. So always see that any number index is 0, answer is always 1. So this is fourth rule. And in fifth rule is a rule of having negative index. So a raised to minus x, it can be converted into positive index as 1 upon a raised to plus x. So if I give one example, 25 raised to minus 4, we can write it as 1 upon 25 raised to plus 4. Negative index can be converted into positive index in this way. So in this way, we have to remember this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rules of indices to solve the sums. First rule is rule of multiplication. Second rule is rule of division. Third rule is a rule having two indices and one base. Fourth rule is rule of index 0. And fifth rule is negative index. So in this way, all five rules you have to remember so that we can solve the sums based on this topic. In practice corner, we have to solve these sums. So we will solve the sums in our notebook. There are two questions in practice corner. First question is study the example in the table below and write the correct number in the blanks. And second example also, we are having this filling the blanks. So let us go on our notebook. So this is my activity sheet number 18. Area is number knowledge and operations on number. Unit is indices and subunit is rules of indices. Practice corner we have to solve in our notebook. So study the examples in the table below and write the correct numbers in the blanks. First is 5 raised to 4 multiplied by 5 raised to 3 multiplication. That means we have to apply the first rule. Same basis multiplication is there, that means we will have to add the indices. Base we write 110. So base is written 110, we have to add indices. 4 plus 3 should be written in fill in the blanks. So answer is 5 raised to 7. 4 plus 3 is 7. So base we have to write as it is. In the index we have to write addition of index. When multiplication is there, we have to add indices. In this way we have to solve the sums. Now second sum, 9 raised to 5 divided by 9 raised to 2. Rule of division we have to apply. So 9 we write one time, base we write one time, and we have to subtract indices. 5 minus 2, 5 minus 2 should be there. So 9 we have to write as it is, and 5 minus 2 answer is 3. 9 raised to 3. Next sum, minus 3, 1 base and 2 indices, 4 and 5. That means what? We have to write base one time and we have to multiply the indices. 4 multiplied by 5. So what is the answer? Minus 3 base as it is we have to write, and 4 5s are 20 is the answer here. Okay. Now 12 raised to 0. Any number raised to 0, answer is always 1. Next one. 11 raised to minus 2. Negative index. Negative index can be written into positive, like when we put 1 in the numerator and 11 raised to plus 2 in the denominator. Plus 2 we have to write here. In this way, you can complete this first chart. And now let us go on the second example. Solve the examples using laws of indices. First example, 13 raised to 5 multiplied by 13 raised to 8. Multiplication is there. Same base, we have to add indices. So base write one time. 13 is the base, we have to write one time and add the indices. 5 plus 8. Write the last step, last answer. 13 as it is we have to write, and 5 plus 8 is again 13. 13 raised to 13, answer is 13 raised to 13. Now second one, minus 4 divided by minus 4, but here the index is 9, here the index is 4. Division is there. Base is minus 4. So minus 4 we write base as it is. As division is there, we will subtract the indices. 9 minus 4. What is the answer? Again minus 4. Base we write. 9 minus 4. What is the answer? 5. Minus 4 raised to 5 is the answer. Now third sum is 4 raised to minus 2 raised to 4. 1 base and 2 indices. So 1 base and 2 indices are there. What we have to do? We have to write base one time and we have to multiply the indices. So base is written one time and we have multiplied the indices here. Minus 2 multiplied by 4. So again 4 as it is we have to write, and minus 2 into 4. We can do this multiplication. It will be minus 8. 4 raised to minus 8. Negative index, how to write it in positive 1? Negative index can be written as equal to 1 in numerator upon 4 raised to positive 8. So 4 raised to 2 minus 2 into 4 is equal to 4 raised to minus 2 multiplied by 4 equal to 4 raised to minus 8 equal to 1 upon 4 raised to plus 8. Now fourth sum is 1, 2, 3, 4 raised to 0. We all know any number raised to 0 answer is 1. And last one is 5. Question is 8 raised to minus 3. So 8 raised to minus 3, we can convert it into the positive index. Negative index will be converted into positive index. So it is 1 upon 8 raised to plus 3 or positive 3. In this way, you can complete all these questions from this Let Us Solve activity. Now see children, in this particular video, we have solved day 17 and day 18th activity sheet number 17 and 18. We will continue the next activity sheets in our next video.